Hello, this is Damian Kirk, demoing or explaining my circuits for CS210, the assignment part 1 and 2. This right here is my 7-segment display, and here's the input. I have these levers on lamps, so you can see whether they're on or off, because the up and down of the levers is a little bit vague, I guess. But you can see I've labeled them 1, 2, 4, and 8. Their values. And basically, I'd like to probably explain this backwards because I think it'll make a little more sense. Each of these segments is being powered by some repeaters that are hooked up to these lines, and each one of these corresponds to one of these bars, one of these like lines that go all the way across. For example, the top one, it feeds in from all the way across into right here. The next one down is this segment that goes along this whole line. Anywhere from along this line is powered, it'll go here and power this segment, turn this segment on. I can't speak sometimes. And then the rest of these, you know, so on and so forth, will be powered. It's hard to see as well right now. I'll turn it to night when I want to actually demonstrate how it works or show that all the states work. But you can see that all of these lines are being powered, all these segments are being powered, except for this middle one, because the middle segment is off, because right now it's set to zero. And basically these bars, these lines that go across here, you can consider to be kind of the OR gates of the PLA. You know, yeah, they have lots of things inputting into them, and if any of them are true, then the line will be on. Because the signal will go all the way through the line. I have some repeaters on some of these to make sure it can make it all the way where it needs to go, especially on this one. The signal needs to be boosted because redstone wire has a limit of 15 blocks that it'll travel before you need to put it through an inverter or repeater or something. So basically, these lines are then being powered by these inputs into them, which are coming from these columns. And these columns are kind of the, I don't remember the term, but each of these corresponds to one of the possible states. And you can see this is a little bit different than the way we learned it, because these are all off when they are receiving a signal and on when they are not receiving a signal. So it's kind of inverted, and then these, the ands are more like nands, really, but it all works out. So, 3, etc., all the way down the line. But this is zero, and you'll notice that basically the way these redstone torches work is if the block that a redstone torch is on is being powered, it will turn off. So right now, this one's not being powered, this block isn't being powered, so this torch is allowed to be on. The rest of these, the bottom torch, is being turned off by the signal from the NAND gates. But this, I use these columns here, and basically they alternate because this, you know, this torch will power this one and turn this one off, which lets this one be on, which turns this one off, etc. But this one is the opposite. They're alternating, you know, oppositely, whatever the word would be. So then I hook this up such that I only hook it up to the torches that are on when the state is, when this, you know, state is supposed to be active, and off when it's not. You notice I don't have any torches hooked up to like the torches that are off in this column or the torches that are on in this column, because that would just be, you know, mix up the signals and stuff. You'd have multiple parts of it. It just wouldn't make any sense. So you'll see I have it coming from these torches that are on, powering this line and this line, because powering this block, it'll power both of these lines. This one powers this line. Nothing's powering this line from this column. But then this is powering these two and this one. So that turns on the 6 segments that we need to make a zero. If you go to this next one, the 1, you'll see there are less of these lines coming out, because all I need to power is this line and this line if it's 1. Right now this 1 is turned off, but if this were on, these lines, these torches would be different. These torches would be on, this torch and this torch specifically, and it would be powering only this one and this one, and those correspond to the right 2 lines. Segments, I should say. So that would be the 1 state. And if you go on down the line, this is 2, 3, 4, you know, you get the idea. As far as where these signals are coming from, like I said, they're kind of inverted. So these are these states are inactive when they're receiving a signal from the NAND gates. These are the NAND gates. They're also kind of this bar structure. but a little bit differently. So this is the one corresponding to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. And then on this side, for the sake of symmetry, I mean, it's a little bit confusing, but then it goes down from here. So it's 8, 9, A, B, C, D, E, F, moving down. So the signal comes out from these, and these structures in the middle here are just ways of propagating the signal straight down. Not straight down, but kind of zigzagging. I should stop saying propagate. It doesn't really apply here, but sending the signal down without having to take up a bunch of space, you know, going in a circle or something. One of the problems with redstone is that it's hard to go down with it, or to take the signal down. But, so you see all of these are powered and outputting a signal into the other states, except for the zero. And the reason for that, it gets a little convoluted in how these actually work. I use a similar alternating torch structure here. Actually invert them just for the sake of making it easy. So, like I said, the state is active when the line is off. So basically, these four torches for this gate correspond to the four bits of input. And you'll notice that they're all outputting zero into this line. Outputting zero into this line. If any of them were outputting one into this line, or, you know, transmitting an actual active signal, then this line would be on, and it would stop the zero from being output. Similarly, if you look at the one here, allowing this line to be off, you know, for the one output to be on, except for this least significant bit. The least significant bit is incorrect for this output, so it is putting a signal in here and suppressing the one state, basically, stopping it from being active. Similarly, here's the two state. The only bit that's preventing that is this one, the second to least significant bit. Because, for example, for the two bit, the second to least significant bit, it needs to be off for this one, so you just can send the off signal through, but it needs to be off for the next one too, because the two bit being zero will allow zero or one, or, you know, a lot of other inputs, or outputs, I mean. But that is the correct state for 0 and 1. But with this alternating structure of input, this is coming through as on, so you have to invert it. So this torch is powering this line, which is powering this block, which is making this torch off. And like I said, so this is the only bit that's wrong for that. This bit's wrong for 2. This is the 3 line. Both of these are incorrect. But these are okay. And you notice this is the first half. This is 0 through 7, so the 8 bit, you know, most significant bit, is okay for any of these outputs because it's going to allow any of these outputs to be on. It's the other bits that are selecting them from among these. And then over here, the 8 bit is preventing any of these because if the 8 bit is off, none of these higher outputs can be correct. So, sometimes up here you'll get signals that have been inverted 10 or so times, but I guess just trust me that it works, that it's inverted the correct number of times, and that only one of these gates will output zero and allow the state to be on at a time. If for any given input of these four bits, there's still only one of these columns is going to be unpowered, and only one of them is going to be outputting into these OR gates. These OR bars that select output. So if I run over here real quick, a lot of other random circuitry stuff with my old counter. I should have built this closer, but flick this switch. This is also like a little, I don't remember. Basically controls whether it's day or night, whether it'll maintain a day or night time. So it'll make it night so we can see this thing and see that it works. And I'll go run through like a kind of gray code Towers of Hanoi kind of circuit of this just to make it faster. So we have one, or we already see the zero works. We switch that to one, we just get the two on the right, and just for this one I'll go ahead and like go see what's happening here. Now the one bit is incorrect for the zero output, but correct for the one output. So this line is off instead of the other one, and it's alternating these torches instead of these. We're getting output from this repeater and this repeater going into the two outputs on the right. I'm not going to do that for every single one of these outputs. I just wanted to show what was going on there. If we click this should be three. good. Six. Come on, six. There it is. It takes a second because there's a lot of delay, especially with the repeater towers. Put the one. That should be seven. Good stuff. This will be five. Five works. Click that. That should give us four after a second. There's our four. This should be C. I feel like I might have lost track of the order here, but yeah, here's C. That should be correct for that sequence. Here is D, then. Here's F. All the bits are on, should be F. Good. Turn this off, it's E. This will be, I want to say 10. I mean A. A is 10, but yeah, that's A. Like that, that should be B. Looks right, that's B. I have lost track, actually. Like that, yeah, this will give us 9. Then this will be just 8, which is all the segments. And if I flick the 8-bit back off, flick the 8-bit back off, whatever, it'll be back to 0. So, see that all of them work. Again, this is a little bit ridiculous and bulky and complex. So, if you need to know any more details about the circuitry, I can, demonstrate in person. If you have specific questions and stuff about how it works. Or, if this is enough, that's also cool. So, there you go. That is my 7-segment display.